Hey guys, and welcome to this lesson. In this lesson, we're going to create our own custom VPC. Now, this will be the configuration that we create. We're going to create a VPC called My VPC. This will be the CIDR block that we use. Now, we're going to use two availability zones in the US East region, 1A and 1B. And in each of the availability zones, we're going to have one public subnet and one private subnet. So they each have a name, public 1A, private 1A, and public 1B, and private 1B. So it's descriptive and helps us understand what availability zone that subnet is actually in. And you can see each of the subnets has its own CIDR block. Now, there'll be two route tables because there's always a main route table when we create a VPC, and that will have a route to an internet gateway, so our public subnets can access the internet. We'll then have a private route table. Now at this point, we'll leave it without a NAT gateway, but if you do want to enable public internet access for your instances in your private subnets, you would also need to launch a NAT gateway in a public subnet and add a route to it. So this is what we're going to create. Let's go to the console. So I'm in the management console, and I'm just going to search for VPC and open the VPC management console. Now in here, I'm in the US East region, so make sure you are also in the US East, North Virginia region. Within this region, if I go to your VPCs, you'll see we already have a VPC. So every region will have a default VPC, and that VPC is going to have subnets in each availability zone in that region, and those will be public subnets. We can see some information about the VPC here. And you'll see, in this case, there are six public subnets because US East has six availability zones. So each of those subnets will be in a different availability zone. There should also be one route table. And that route table will have a route to the internet via an internet gateway, and it will have a local route for routing within the VPC. So that's our default VPC. What we want to do is create our own custom VPC. Make sure you've downloaded the course download from the end of section one. Open the VPC folder and you will find this file, custom-vpc.md. So if you open this, it's going to give you lots of the values that you need when you're creating the VPC. For example, we have the name of the VPC here, and then we have the CIDR block. Back in the console, under your VPCs, I'm going to click Create VPC. Now here we have a couple of options. We can choose to use the VPC only option, where we specify our information here, or we can choose VPC and more, and it actually starts creating the VPC with certain configurations. And you can see here, for example, it's going to create two subnets in US East 1A, two in 1B. It's going to create the route tables, the network connections, very similar to what we want to do. And you can actually go in and then choose, let's say, free availability zones, and it will create more subnets. You can choose the number of private subnets you want. And so it's really helpful. It helps you to create this configuration. You can see visually here what it looks like. And you can choose NAT gateways in 1AZ or 1 per AZ so that you have redundancy for your NAT gateways as well. Now, I'm not going to use that option. I want to do it manually. So I'm going to choose VPC only. I'm going to paste in my name tag, and then I want to put in my address. So I'm going to copy this whole CIDR block to my clipboard. And then here where it says IPv4 CIDR, I'm just going to paste it in exactly like that. So those are the settings we need to define. We're not going to use an IPv6 CIDR block. Default tenancy is fine. And it's going to add a name tag for us. So let's just create the VPC. That's it. We now have a VPC, but it doesn't have anything in it. So all we have is the VPC. We don't have any subnets yet, and we don't have our private route table. So let's click on subnets. Here I'm going to choose to create subnet. I'm going to choose my VPC from the drop-down list. So obviously we're going to choose my VPC. And now we can add in the subnet settings, and we can add new subnet here. So what we're going to do is fill them out one by one. Let's start with the first one. The first subnet is public 1A. So I'm going to copy the name, paste that in. This one is going to be in the US East 1A availability zone. So the name should match the availability zone, 1A and 1A. Then let's get the CIDR block. The CIDR block should be 10.0.1.0.24. So I'm going to paste that one in. And that's the first subnet defined. Then I can click Add New Subnet and put the second one in. And I'm basically going to repeat those exact steps for the next three subnets. Now I've skipped forward and completed all four exactly as per the document. So we've got public 1A in US East 1A with a CIDR block 10.0.1.0.24, public 1B in US East 1B 10.0.2.0.24, and so on. We then have these two private subnets. Okay, so that's it. We can now choose Create Subnet, and it will create all four subnets for us. So we have our four subnets. Now, of course, two of these are supposed to be public subnets. The bottom two here, public 1A and public 1B. Now, if we scroll over to the right-hand side here, we'll find this option here that says Auto Assign Public IPv4 Address. Now, it's currently set to no. That means these are not actually configured to assign public addresses to our instances, which we do need to do for these to be public subnets. So what we need to do is one by one, we need to enable that option. So with public 1A highlighted, I'm going to go to Actions and then Edit Subnet Settings. And I'm going to enable the box here to auto assign public IPv4 addresses and then save. And then I'm going to repeat that with public 1B, edit subnet settings, and again, enable the auto assignment of public IPv4 addresses. Great, so I've got those. Now let's go and have a look at what else has been created. Now we will need an internet gateway, but we don't have one at the moment. So let's create our internet gateway. So back in the document, we'll skip down to create internet gateway and simply copy the name that we're going to assign. Back in the console, click Create Internet Gateway, put in the name tag, and then create. We've now created the internet gateway, but it's not attached to a VPC. So select Actions, Attach to VPC, and if you click in the box here, it should show you the VPC that we can assign it to. And we'll click on Attach. That's our internet gateway attached. Now we need to make sure that there's a route to the internet gateway from the route table that we're using for our public subnets. So let's go to Route Tables, and if we expand here, we can see the route table that's being created for the new VPC, the custom VPC. So we'll select this one here, go to Routes, click on Edit Routes, and we're going to click on Add. If you just click in this box here, you'll see this option, which is all zeros. Remember, that means every other address that's not within the CIDR block for the VPC. So everything that's destined anywhere else but the CIDR block for the VPC should go via the internet gateway. And it finds the internet gateway for us. We can click on Save, and now we have a route. Now what subnets are actually assigned? Let's have a look. So you can see there's no explicit subnet associations. That's normal. With the main route table for the VPC, no subnets are explicitly defined by default, but they are implicitly associated. So these four are all currently associated. Now, of course, we don't want our private subnets associated with the main route table, but that's okay. We're next going to create a route table just for the private subnets, and we're going to then assign explicitly those subnets to that route table. So let's click back on route tables, choose create route table, and back in the document here, we're going to call this one private-rt. So I'm going to put that name tag in, choose to select a VPC and select my VPC, and then create route table. So we've got it now. What we need to do is make sure we associate our private subnets. So we come into subnet associations, click on edit, and we're going to choose private 1A and private 1B. And then click on save. That's it. We now have the explicit associations for the private subnets. If we go and look at the main route table for our VPC, which will be this one here, let's click on the ID, go to subnet associations, we can now see that only the public subnets are associated with this route table, and that's exactly what we want. So coming back to our diagram, we now have public subnets in US East 1A and 1B, private subnets in both availability zones as well. We've created an internet gateway and attached a route to the main route table so that the instances in the public subnet can go to the internet via the internet gateway. We've also created a private route table for our private subnets, which currently are completely detached from the internet, which may be good in many use cases. Of course, sometimes you will want to attach them to the internet for outbound traffic so that they can access things like repositories for downloading updates. And in that case, you would launch a NAT gateway in a public subnet and then add the route. Now, why don't we go ahead and do that so you can see how it's done. So what we'll do is we'll create a NAT gateway in the public 1A subnet and we'll add a route to the internet via the NAT gateway in the private route table. Back in the console, we're going to choose NAT gateways, create NAT gateway, and then we're going to give it a name. So we're going to call this one my NAT gateway, and it's going to be attached to the public 1A subnet. So I add this in, choose the public 1A subnet, which is in the correct VPC. Now note that this is public and we need to allocate the Elastic IP. Now we don't have any in our accounts, so we need to choose allocate. It will allocate the Elastic IP and then we can create the NAT gateway. So that's been created. What we can now do is go back to route tables, choose our private RT route table, go to routes, edit routes, add, again, click in the box, choose the all zeros, click in the box for target, and choose NAT gateway, and select your NAT gateway. And that's it. You can now save changes. So that's it. We've created the VPC. We've added in a NAT gateway now, which we can use for internet access from the private subnets. And of course, we have an internet gateway so that our public subnets can access the internet. So that's everything that we needed to do. We've now got our custom VPC fully set up and our instances in both the private and public subnets should be able to access the internet outbound. And we should be able to access our public instances from the internet as well. Now, the only thing here that does cost money is the NAT gateway. So I wanted to show you how to do it, but you might not want to leave it running. So if you're not going to use it, I would get rid of your NAT gateway. So we can simply come to NAT gateways, choose actions, and delete NAT gateway. Type delete in the box and delete. Now, when you do that, it's going to delete the NAT gateway, but it's going to leave behind the Elastic IP. Now, you remember I told you earlier in the course, you pay for Elastic IPs only when you're not using them. So once this is deleted, we should be able to remove the Elastic IP. So that took less than a minute. It is now deleted. And what I can do is click on Elastic IPs and we can see the Elastic IP here. It's selected. I'm going to go to Actions, Release Elastic IP, and then Release. So that's gone. Now, this shouldn't have cost us any money because the NAT gateway was only running for a few minutes and the Elastic IP was only unattached for a few seconds. So that's it for this lesson. We've now created our custom VPC and it's ready to use. Now, none of the other components that we created, including the internet gateway, are going to cost us any money. So we can just leave this VPC running in our account and use it when we need to.